Here at Worldwide, we have a great time on all of our trips, but we also have a certain set of guidelines and rules that we follow and we like everyone else to follow to help take care of our passengers. The first of those rules is the proper wearing of a life jacket. We have Type 5 life jackets that are for all of our passengers that have been Coast Guard approved and are exactly what we use in order to float properly in the water, whether it's swimming or falling out of the boat. Oftentimes people will want to bring their own life jackets, and unfortunately, we don't allow those on the river. So if you're thinking of bringing one of those, we have life jackets that we'll provide for you. Once we get to the river, we encourage people to swim and cool off. We don't want anyone to get dehydrated or heat exhausted, but in order to jump into the river, we want to make sure everyone goes feet first. That is because the Colorado River is always pretty dirty and you can't see the bottom. So ask your guides where a good place to swim is and make sure and jump in feet first. The next thing is, please don't jump boat to boat. Oftentimes people will splash each other and want to get water fighting a little bit, and they have the urge to jump from one boat to the other, but that's when accidents happen, and we want to make sure that nobody gets hurt on the trips as best as we can. Also on the same line as that, we have paddles that are used for paddling and they aren't used for splashing. Sometimes your urge is to splash with that paddle, but it could skip off of the water, or you could lose control of it and it could hit another person, causing an injury or something of that sort. Make sure that as we're water fighting and such, we're courteous and kind, and we're thinking of other people. If they don't want to be splashed, please don't water fight with them, but make sure that we're having a good time. If someone happens to fall overboard, the best thing to do in that case is get back to the boat, which most often you're right next to the boat. Get back to the boat, you'll grab onto the rope along the outsides of the boats, as you can see on these boats, and then you pull yourself back up as someone grabs your shoulder straps on the life jacket and pulls you in as well. It's kind of a teamwork thing, and it makes it easier to get back into the boats. If you happen to float further away from the boat, we have what's called a throw bag, which is 75 feet of rope that we can throw to you, that you'll grab the rope, put it over your shoulder, and then we'll pull you back to the boat and then pull you back in, just like the other way. Should the raft flip over, we want to make sure that we get back to the boat, just like always, grab onto that rope, and then the guide will be there to help instruct on what to do next. If something is to happen on the river, an accident or a small cut or injury, we do have first aid kits available, and our guides are trained in basic first aid and CPR. We live in a high desert, and in the high desert, it doesn't rain very often. Because of that, we want to make sure that we pick up after ourselves with garbage and other things that we drop on the beach. We call it microtrash, so if you hear guides saying that, that's what we're talking about. Be considerate. Lots of people use these beaches every single day, so we want to make sure and take care of the places that we are. The river is constantly moving, and because of that, we want to make sure that we stay in the boats or swimming near the boats, and we don't pull over to the side and start hiking off on our own. The reason for that is, like I said, it moves downstream and you'll get left behind, and we wanna make sure that everybody stays together as a group. As far as human waste is concerned, or using the bathroom, a lot of times that raises a little bit of concern. No need to fear. We do have porta potties or outhouses that are at the beginning and the ends of each of the trips, also at campsites. And if it is an emergency, please talk to the guides, let them know there are places along the river where we can stop. We are aware of the needs that women and girls may have on the trips, so please feel free to come and talk to one of the guides, and we'll be flexible and be able to work with you. Because of the climate here, it's very, very hot and very, very dry. We want to make sure that everyone wears lots of sunscreen and drinks lots of water. Hydration is happiness. Please let us know if anyone has any food allergies. If they have a food allergy regarding like peanuts or any other allergy, we can have them go first before we put out peanut butter, something like that. But the biggest thing is that we need to know and be aware of those allergies before the trip. Inflatable kayaks are used depending on the water level, and if they are used, it's important that those that are in the kayaks listen to the guides. Another thing with the kayaks is we want to make sure that they stay close to and behind one of the bigger boats that has the guides in it, so that they don't miss lunch or any other pullover, and that they don't get too far ahead so as to receive the proper guidance in rapids. This information will be given at the beginning of each trip, as well as other information depending on which section of river you are on.